We thank God for another beautiful day like this. The day of the Lord. The first day of the week. And he has already planned to bless us today. Being the first day of the week. With the first blessings of the week. And I pray. You will not be left out in Jesus' name. So, this morning we are here again to hear from him. And I pray he will speak to you this morning. He will minister to your needs this morning. And it shall be well with each and every one at the end of this of the telecast in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So let us pray.
Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. We appreciate you for what you have been doing. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for you have been so kind. We thank you for the transformation of life. We thank you for restoration. We thank you for great and mighty things that you have been doing through the course of this telecast since inception. We thank you for you have been proving yourself as the mighty man in battle. Father, we give you all the glory. We give you all the adoration. We give you all the honor. May your name be praised in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are the Father of light, in whom there is no variableness nor shadow of turning. Our prayer today is that you will lead your heart, your light, into every heart today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That through your word today, you will flush away every flux of sin in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And that your master plan for today's broadcast, you will accomplish it in every life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
At the end of this telecast, your name alone will be glorified in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And the celebration, the blessing shall be ours in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you for your God.
Thank you,
Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name I pray.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So this morning we want to look at damnable consequence of compromise. Damnable consequence of compromise. If I may ask, what is a compromise? Compromise is like shifting your ground towards the other side. God Almighty has set us a standard. He has given us a warning. And by the time we now shift a bit from that standard, from that warning, then we are compromising our faith. So we are taking our text from the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 1 to 6, then verses 16 to 18 and 24. Now this happened. Was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, Yea, hath God said, Ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, Ye shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest ye die. And the serpent said unto the woman, Ye shall not surely die. For God hath known that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as God, knowing good and evil. Verse 6. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. In verse 16, then we can see what they have done now. They've already compromised.
wọ́n ti gbọ̀dẹ̀ gẹ̀rẹ́.
And in verse 16.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹrìndínlógún.
Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception. In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband, and he shall rule over thee. And unto Adam he said, because thou hast hearkened to the voice of thy wife, and hast eaten of the tree of which I commanded thee, saying, thou shalt not eat of it, cause it is the ground for thy sake. In sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the days of thy life. And thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the heart of the half of the field. And in verse 24, so he drove out the man. That's God Almighty. Because of that compromise, he drove out the man.
Nítorí ìgbọ̀jẹ̀gẹ́ yìí, ó lé ọkùnrin náà jáde.
Where they will have been enjoying, he drove them out of comfort.
Níbi ìtura ní tí ẹkọ́ ti máa gbádùn, ó lé wọn jáde.
He drove them out of peace of mind, joy of heart.
Ó lé wọn jáde kúrò nínú ìfọ̀kànbalẹ̀, kúrò nínú ayọ̀ ọkàn.
And he placed at the east of the garden of Eden cherubims and a flaming sword which turned every way to keep the way of the tree of life, so that they will not be able to even plan of coming back. I pray the Lord God Almighty will help us, so that we will not compromise in any way, in any form, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, the question is this. Just as we have read, what do you think can lead to individual, family, even a nation compromising?
Kí ni wọ́n lè mú kí ẹnì kọ̀ọ̀kan tàbí ìdílé tàbí orílẹ̀-èdè gan kí wọ́n gbọ̀dẹ̀gẹ́?
There are so many factors.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àwọn
ohun àlọ́ lè fà á. There are so many things that can make one as an individual or as a family to compromise.
Oríṣiríṣi nǹkan ni ó lè fà á gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹnì kọ̀ọ̀kan tàbí ìdílé láti gbọ̀dẹ̀gẹ́.
I will just give us three.
Màá fún wa ní àkókò mẹ́ta.
Out of many reasons.
Láàrin ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àwọn èrèdí tí wọ́n lè fi.
Number one is fear or fearfulness.
Ọ̀kan nínú rẹ̀ náà ni ìbẹ̀rù.
Greed or greediness. Number three is covetousness.
Ojú kòkòrò.
Now let's look at fear
or
fearfulness.
Tàbí kí ẹ̀kọ́ máa bẹ̀rù.
In 1 Samuel chapter 13.
Nínú Sábẹ́lì kìíní orí kẹtàlá.
1 Samuel chapter 13.
Samuel kìíní orí kẹtàlá.
And we read verses 11 and 12.
A ka ẹsẹ̀ kọkànlá àti ìkejìlá.
Verses 11 and 12.
Ìkọkànlá àti ìkejìlá.
Now this is a time when Moses, when instruction was given to the first king in Israel, that is Saul. So there are offices, kingship, priestship, and so on and so forth. Now, it is not right for a king to offer any sacrifice unto that. It means it will be delving into the office of a priest.
Eléyìí jẹ́ àkókò nílẹ̀ Ísírẹ́lì tó jẹ́ pé a fún àwọn èèyàn ní ojúṣe, oníkálukú ní ojúṣe tiẹ̀, ipò ọba, ipò àwọn àlùfáà. Gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọba, kò yẹ kí ọba kó lọ ṣiṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ àlùfáà. Tó bá lọ gbé ìgbésẹ̀ yìí, ó túmọ̀ sí pé ó ti ṣe ẹsẹ̀ gbé.
And in this case, in this situation, Saul the king offered sacrifice unto God, whereas it's not his duty to do that.
Níbi tí a fẹ́ kà yìí, ọba tí ṣe Sọ́ọ̀lù, ó lọ ṣe ìrúbọ fún Ọlọ́run, eléyìí tí yẹ pé kì í ṣe epo tirẹ̀ láti ṣe eléyìí.
Meanwhile, when eventually Samuel came back,
nígbà tí Samuel wá padà dé,
the king Saul started to give excuses
Oba ti se Saul o bere si sawawi.
So when we read from verse 11 now, that's 1 Samuel chapter 13.
Se ba bere kika re lati ese e kokola ile ti se Samuel kini ori ketala.
And Samuel said, "What hast thou done?" And Saul said, "Because I saw that the people were scattered from me, and that thou camest not within the days appointed, and that the Philistines gathered themselves together at Michmash. Therefore said I, the Philistines will come down now upon me to Gilgal, and have not made supplication unto the Lord." It's not his duty to do that, to make supplication unto the Lord. And why? Because it's not the priest. Instead of him to wait for the priest to come and do that, he said, "I forced myself. Therefore, and offer a burnt offering." And Samuel said unto Saul, "You have done foolishly. Why should you do this? It's not your duty. It's not your office." So here we can see that Saul has compromised his stand, his office already.
Ti a ba wo bi ti a kan yi, a ri pe Saul o ti bo jeje kuro ni ipo re gangan.
Why? Because of fear.
Kini ji
nitori e? Because the Philistine will come upon me, more so the people that have started scattering away from me. And when I saw that, oh, if I didn't do this thing, the Philistines will overrun me, and I forced myself.
O bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ṣàwá wí níwájú Samuel wípé èdè ní tí mo fi ṣe èyí tí mo fi bẹ́ẹ̀ gbésẹ̀ yìí ni pé mò ń wò wípé àwọn Filistini wọ́n lè wá kí wọ́n wá sí ọ̀dọ̀ mi, ìdílé eléyìí tí mo fi ti ara mi láti lọ ṣe ohun tí mo ṣe.
Especially this time around of COVID-19.
Pàápàá jùlọ nínú àkókò tí a wà
yìí tí àjàkálẹ̀ COVID-19. There's a lockdown everywhere.
Tí a sì sọ pé káwọn èèyàn kan máa jáde.
Some people, they will compromise their faith in the Lord.
Àwọn mìíràn wọ́n máa gbọ̀jẹ̀ jẹ́ ìgbàgbọ́ wọn nínú Olúwa.
On the basis that, oh, things are so tough now, how can I continue this way? I need to make this, I need to make money, I need to make that through dubious means so that I can sustain myself.
Àwọn mìíràn wá bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní máa gbọ̀jẹ̀ jẹ́. Wọ́n á wò pé nǹkan tó fà náà ni pé gbogbo wọn ti le jù. Mo ní láti gbé ìgbésẹ̀ báyìí. Kì í ṣe nǹkan báyìí kí lè rí pé èmi náà mo jẹ mo yó.
They will tell you, "Well, I'm sorry, it's not my plan to do it." Like a woman going into adultery, or a lady going into fornication. "Well, it's not my will, it's not my wish, but look at the situation. Things are so hard, and I forced myself into this prostitution. I forced myself into this ungodly act."
Àárọ̀ ìyá lè fi ṣàpẹẹrẹ obìnrin tó lọ ṣe àgbèrè tàbí ọ̀dọ́bìnrin obìnrin tó lọ ṣe paṣágà tàbí ọ̀dọ́bìnrin tó lọ ṣe àgbèrè ló wá sọ pé ó wà bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ṣàwárí pé kì í ṣe èmi náà nígbà tí mo rí gbogbo nǹkan ṣe rí gbogbo nǹkan ti le jù ló mú mi lọ gbé ìgbésẹ̀ yìí láti ṣe ohun tí ò tọ́.
But your best excuse to compromise your faith will not please the Lord.
Ohun tó wà bẹ́ẹ̀ náà ni pé àwáwí tó dára jùlọ láti ẹnu rẹ láti gbọ̀jẹ̀gẹ́ kò lè tẹ Ọlọ́run lọ́rùn.
It is good to stand by the word, by the standard of the word of God.
Ó dára ká dúró níha àgbékalẹ̀ òtítọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
Don't compromise.
Má ṣe gbọ̀jẹ̀gẹ́.
It is only tough time that lasts, tough time doesn't last.
Àwọn èèyàn tó lè pọ́nrún ló máa ń pẹ́ ṣùgbọ́n àkókò tó lè pọ́nrún kò yí pẹ́ rárá.
This time of lockdown, it will soon be over.
Àkókò má jáde yìí yóò kò ní pẹ́ dópin.
Now for Saul as a king to have compromised, what was the consequence?
Fún ọba tí ṣe Saul láti gbọ̀jẹ̀gẹ́ kí wá ni àwọn àbájáde tó ti lè jáde.
Look at verse 13, that is 1 Samuel chapter 13 and in verse 13.
Ǹjẹ́ ká wo Samuel kí ni orí kẹtàlá ẹsẹ̀ kẹtàlá? Samuel sì fún Saul pé, "Ìfọ́ kò kú ìwà ọlọ́gbọ́n, ìwọ kò pa òfin Olúwa Ọlọ́run rẹ mọ́ tí òun ti pa ní àṣẹ fún ọ, nítorí nísinsìnyí ni Olúwa ìbá fi ìdí ìjọba rẹ kalẹ̀." Lórí Israẹli láéláé, ṣùgbọ́n nísinsìnyí ìjọba rẹ kì yóò dúró pẹ́. Olúwa ti wá fún ara rẹ̀ ọkùnrin tí ó wù ú ní ọkàn rẹ̀. Olúwa pàṣẹ fún ọ kí ìwọ kí o ṣe olórí fún
Saul and his generation will have been ruling over Israel. That's forever. But because of that compromise, the plan of God for his life, family, generation, lineage got destroyed. In Revelation 21. Revelation 21. The fearful. Some people, I wanted to move to the side of the law, but my in-laws, they are threatening me that if I should move to the side of the Lord, they will eject me out of my husband's house. So the fearful, let's look at Revelation 21 verse 8. Eternal damnation for the fearful. So, Boko, be strong in the Lord. Be remain on the side of the Lord. And he will see you through.
Amen.
So you can see the fearful and all other vices. They are in the same group. The abominable, the murderers, the whoremongers, the sorcerers, the idolaters, the liars. The liars. The liars. Hell. But if you can change today, your soul will not be damned in eternity in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That's number one. I will just consider three factors. The first one, I've dealt with fear. The other one is greed or greediness. Greed or greediness. Let's look at Matthew 26. Matthew chapter 26. Verse 14. Through to 16. Then one of the 12 called Judas Iscariot went unto the chief priests and said unto them, what will ye give me? And I will deliver him unto you. And they covenanted with him for 30 pieces of silver. And from that time, he sought opportunity to betray him. That is to betray Jesus. Yes.
Nígbà náà ni ọ̀kan nínú àwọn méjìlá tí a ń pè ní Judas Iscariot sọ àwọn olórí àlùfáà lọ, ó sì ní pé kí ni ẹ̀yin yóò fi fún mi, èmi ó sì fi lé yín lọ́wọ́. Wọ́n sì bá ṣe àdéhùn 30 owó fàdákà. Láti ìgbà náà lọ ló sì ti ń wá ọ̀nà láti fi lé wọn lọ́wọ́.
Remember, he's the one in charge of the pulse.
Ẹrántí wípé òun ni akápò.
But greediness.
Ṣùgbọ́n àwọn àgbọ̀bíà.
The one is he was stealing from the pulse is not enough.
Èto ti ń jí tẹ́lẹ̀ tó ń yọ jí kò tí tó.
And he wants more.
Ó tún fẹ́ sí i.
And at the end of the day, he didn't get anything.
Lẹ́yìn ọ̀rẹ́ ìbò tí ẹ̀ wá rí nǹkan gbà.
In John chapter 12.
Nínú ìwé Jòhánù orí kejìlá.
John chapter 12.
Jòhánù orí kejìlá.
Verses 5 and 6.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkarùn-ún sí ìkẹfà.
John 12, 5 and 6.
Èéṣe tí a kò fi ta òróró ìkunra yìí ní ọdún owó idẹ káàsì fi fún àwọn tálákà, ṣùgbọ́n ó wí èyí kì í ṣe nítorí tí ó máa ní àwọn tálákà, ṣùgbọ́n nítorí tí í ṣe olè òun ni ó sì ní àpò a sì máa gbé ohun sí àti sínú rẹ̀.
He was the one keeping the pulse.
Òun ló ń fi àpò ló fowó pamọ́.
He was in charge of the treasury.
Ohun gbogbo tó wà lọ́wọ́ wọn ò ló fi pamọ́.
Jesus Christ knew that he's a thief, he's been stealing from the treasury.
Jésù olúwa
that is not being faithful. Now, that one was not enough for him. And look at he has already assessed the value of the ointment that had been applied on Jesus. How did he know this? And it's under pretense that, oh, you will have sold this thing. Why are you lavishing this thing on Jesus? Why are you obeying the law, the commandment of the word of God? Why can't you compromise a bit? Why can't you mellow down a bit? We can sell this thing and then collect so much. Not that he's having the love of the people of the poor in his heart, but because he's a thief. Now, greediness. Where did they lead him to? In Matthew 27.
Matthew 27.
Verses 4 and 5.
O si wi pe emi se ni eyi ti mo fi eja la ise han won si wi pe kokan wa ma boju to o si da owo fadaka na sile ni temple o si jade o si lo iso
he hung himself
o lo so ara re
and I don't know, I think he should be in heaven now according to your own assessment. So greediness will lead you to do what you are not supposed to do. And now look at it. He collected 30 pieces of silver. He sinned against God. He sinned against Jesus. He collected the money. He couldn't spend the money. So you can see the vanity of greediness. I pray that will not be your portion.
Amen.
I say that will not be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You remember Gehazi as well? You remember the trick he played? And at the end of the day, he damned his soul as well. Now, the third one. We have seen fearfulness. We have seen greediness. Now, covetousness. Covetousness. Taking what does not belong to you. Appropriating what does not belong to you to yourself. There are so many in the Bible. But we will look at Achan. Let's look at Achan in the book of Joshua. Joshua in the book of Joshua. Despite that the fact that the children of Israel, they were warned. Never you touch anything. In Joshua chapter 7. Verse 19. Through to 21.
Joshua si ni fun Akani pe omo mi mo be o ki ogo fun Oluwa Olorun Israeli ki o si jewo fun ki o si so fun mi nisisiyi ohun ti iwo se ma se pa mo fun mi Akani si da Joshua lohun o si wi pe ni tooto ni mo se si Oluwa Olorun Israeli bayi ni mo se.
Wait there for a moment. Now for this sin of Achan, problem came upon the children of Israel. They couldn't stand before their enemy. So it means when you are compromising your faith,
it will
be difficult for you to stand before your enemies. And when this thing happened, Joshua, this is very, very unusual. Where is our God that has been defending us all this while? Joshua went before the Lord.
Joshua lost what you do.
And Achan was exposed.
As to Ashiakani.
Now Joshua now called Achan.
Joshua walked with Achani.
Why have you done this for God's sake? That's in verse 19 and verse 20. Eventually he confessed. But it's too late. The confession was too late. You see, some people when they have done something wrong and you call them. You challenge them. Instead of them to go straight immediately, sorry, it is true, I've done this.
And
I'm promising I will not do it again.
I'm
repenting in dust and ashes.
They
wouldn't do that. They will dribble you. Look at Achan. A lot of steps were taken before his family was fished out. Now the question is, where have you done this, Achan?
In
verse 21.
Ati didi wura kan olosuwon adota shekeli bo soju kokoro won mo si mu won shawo ati won pa mo ni ile laarin ago mi ati fadaka na la bere.
He said when I saw
ori
Babylonian's garment,
ori e Babyloni,
he saw Google things of the heathen,
ori awon to dara ti afi pamo,
and he said, I converted, I took, I stole, I brought them to my house, I appropriated them to my tent, and here am I.
Olemire, mo soju kokoro won, mo mu won, mo ko won so lara mi, mo si fi won sinu ago mi.
There is no ignorance in love.
Ko si ma agbagbe bi iwo pe ninu ofin.
There is no ignorance in love.
Once the law,
in fact, the scripture says, law is not meant for the righteous, but for sinners, for adulterers, for idolaters, for whoremongers. Remember Gehazi, I made mention of it, he was covetous. His master said, freely given, freely I receive from God this power I'm using, freely I give it out. And he has given it out to benefit Naaman. And now, when let's quickly look at 2 Kings chapter 5. Chapter 5. In verse 5. 2 Kings chapter 5. Let us see what attracted Gehazi. Let us see what made him to covet, what he coveted. Can you imagine how many talents of silver, 10 talents of silver, 6,000 pieces of gold, and 10 changes of raiment? That's all what sent Gehazi to damnation. And look at it, one sin will lead to another. Where we read in the book of Revelation 21, he made mention of liars, made mention of the fearful, he made mention of so many other vices. Because Gehazi coveted those things and he started to tell lies in verse 20. But they are. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So I said, one sin will lead to another sin. Sin of covetousness has led Gehazi to another sin of lying. But because of this, what's the consequence? In verse 26 and
27.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see, when you are dealing with a genuine prophet, God sent prophet, they are the best to relate with. They are the best to work with. And at the same time, they are the most dangerous people to work with.
So
it's like when you are relating with a good prophet, you are the one that will choose which one you want to take from him. If you look at that verse 26, as he's committing these sins, nothing was hidden from the prophet. Except the prophet doesn't want to talk. So what am I saying? Under a genuine prophet, there is no hidden place for evil doers. And I pray today we will repent.
Amen.
Whether prophet talks or not, the cause will be there. Especially a prophet that is so humble, caring, that can give his head unto you. And you are now hiding somewhere to do evil. It's like you are cursing yourself. That individual will be cursing himself. And if you are doing well, you are blessing yourself. So it's a two-edged sword to walk with a prophet. And I pray we will not incur the wrath of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now the fearfulness, the greediness, the covetousness, what happened? All this tends to enriching oneself. They want to enrich themselves. And look at what we follow in Proverbs 10. Proverbs chapter 10. In verse 22. In verse 22, the blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich, and he added no sorrow with it. Now, look at all these people that have enriched themselves. Were they free from the sorrow of God?
Gehazi,
was he free?
Gehazi.
Achan, was he free? Just look at them. So it is only when you allow God to bless you, because today is a prosperity Sunday. It is when you allow God to prosper you in a genuine way that there will be no sorrow. And all these people we have made mention of, they are now where? In hell.
So
if you want to be genuinely rich here on earth and still make heaven, what must you do? In Matthew, the book of Matthew, chapter 16.
Matthew
16.
Matthew 16.
And verse 26. That is it. Did they get anything to replace their soul? Nothing. So before we pray,
in
Matthew chapter 11, verse 12. The kingdom of God suffered what?
Violence.
Right from the beginning of the world. And it is only those that are violent that will take it by force. So what are we saying today? You want to be rich and still make heaven. What must you do? You must be violent with fear. You must be violent with greed. And you must be violent with covetousness. If you can do all this, it shall be well with you.
Mm-hmm.
It shall be well with me.
Mm-hmm.
It shall be well with your family.
Mm-hmm.
And together we will make it to the end in Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
Let's rise up to pray to the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Let's begin to appreciate God for a beautiful day like this that the Lord has sent a very beautiful word to us. A very instructive message the Lord has sent to us this morning. Today is a special day. Let's appreciate him for his good mind, good intention towards us. That is why he has sent this good word unto us.
Appreciate
him for what he intends to do through this word this morning. For what he has been doing already through this word. Thank you, Jesus. 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 We appreciate you. 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 Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Because he loves us. That is why he has shared his mind with us this morning. We are in a generation where there is that of truth. Now let's appreciate him for this truth that he has shared with us this morning. It's the truth that the Lord always share with heaven bound Christians. We appreciate. He said he wants us to appreciate him for the word that he has sent out this morning. I want you to appreciate him very well. Appreciate him. Many people, they are longing, they are panting for such a word like this. They don't have. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we appreciate you. We appreciate you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
He said we should appreciate him for what he intends to do for the few moments ahead. He said he is God, that he wants to prove himself as the I am that I am for these few moments.
He has
designed to do something very special this morning. He said we should appreciate him for that. Let's appreciate him. For the great and mighty thing that the Lord wants to do, even this moment ahead of us,
we appreciate
you. For the great and mighty things you intend to do, we appreciate you. For what you have in mind to do, for what you want to accomplish in our midst this morning, we thank you. For what you want to do in every life, thank you for destinies that you want to move. We appreciate you. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. We shall get now. You are the Father of light. There is no variableness with you, nor shadow of time. Yes, we appreciate you. We thank you. Every good and perfect gift comes from you. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
One of the greatest losers in the Bible. Is the man that we mentioned this morning that threw the message. There are so many losers in the Bible. We have so many winners in the Bible. But one of the greatest losers, if not the greatest, is Gehazi. You know, Elisha received double portion of Elijah's anointing. And by calculation, Gehazi was supposed to receive the four times portion, that is the quadruple portion of that anointing of Elisha. No wonder Elisha carried the fire even to the grave. When a dead man was thrown into the grave of Elisha, the man stood up immediately. That was the fire Gehazi was supposed to receive. He was supposed to be the greatest man in the Bible, the greatest prophet. When you begin to read the book of 2 Kings further, this man became a tale bearer in the palace of a king. He was telling the stories of exploits of Elisha. He was just employed. Tell us the story. A man that was supposed to be one of the greatest prophets in the Bible. He was a loser. There are some people that this message, you know, there is no doubt that the message is very clear. Yeah, I don't need to talk more about it. The message is very straightforward and very clear. There is a particular youth, you are listening to this message. You are eating the forbidden fruit now. You are destroying your future, your glorious future. Because that girl that you are sleeping with, he is siphoning the glory of your future. Some people they are taking the Babylonian garment of today, compromise. Because and they at the expense of their glorious future. They never knew that the garments of today, they are the rags of tomorrow. The garments. The Babylonian garment, that garment that look attractive to you, that you are wearing. That you are converting. They are destroying your good future. We want to talk to God now.
Lord,
I'm a compromiser.
Please
tell him the way it is. There are some people, they are watching me now. They are automatic lying machine. They can lie at a fraction of an instant. They lie like a machine. Today is the day of repentance. You know you are an hypocrite. You know yourself, you are very greedy. Please do not hide yourself. Talk to God now. Talk to God now. Because the Lord wants to do something great today. When the ministration was going on, he told me, he said, today that I want to mold destinies in conformity with my plan and purpose. Because compromise has derailed so many destinies. Oh, let's talk to God. Let's talk to God. He said, I should give people time to settle with him. Talk to God. I will talk to God myself. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
You are still going to pray that prayer the second time. I mean business this morning concerning this message.
Let me
put this right. God mean business. While the musician was going on, the Lord told me, said there are people in this assembly that is saying the same time.
Only end time.
That they are dealing with my servants.
Hypocritically.
That's a servant, Prophet Omelewa.
He
said today is giving them another opportunity to repent. Please do not say, what are you saying again? You, this young man. I am committed to tell you the truth. It doesn't matter what it cost me. You are a hypocrite. You are bat-like in your character. You are like a bat. You have to repent this morning. Let's begin to talk to God. Everybody, let's begin to talk to God. The Lord said there are many hypocrites. Many hypocrites. He said he want them to repent this morning. Because that your heart of hypocrisy, it will destroy and maim your destiny. It's haunting your destiny already. Your destiny is like your destiny is haunted. But you need to repent this morning. There's a particular woman that is monitoring this program. You are, I don't know the adjective to use. Your conventionalness is alarming. It's highly alarming. Please repent. As men that are conventions, and you know that you are conventions. Whatever your highest desire is what you want to have for yourself. There is a man in the Bible that he had everything his highest desire. After everything, it's a vanity upon vanity, everything under the sun. Repent this morning. Repent this morning. Yes. Compromise is a deadly poison. Yes, it will poison your destiny. It will poison you. It will not allow you to accomplish destiny, just like it did to Gehazi. There is a particular man.
You are not faithful to your wife.
Okay.
Like that percent of your income you are spending on concubines outside.
And
against this money. Today is the day of salvation. Don't delay. Delay can be dangerous. So repent and talk to me. The Lord is still giving you another chance. The Lord said there is large room for people that are ready to repent this morning.
Yes.
We have just 2 minutes to do that. After that 2 minutes, something great will begin to happen in the life of people that cooperated. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The Lord said there is a particular man, you are watching this program. You are a serial liar. No, serial. When you have serial killer, people that you lie at ease. You can lie anytime. When they wake up very early in the morning, you can just give a lie at a fraction of an instant. But now that you have had the word, you are ready to repent. The Lord said is bringing back your stolen glory. He said what the enemy has taken away from you because of that your perpetual art of lying. The Lord is restoring them now. Said there are many that belong to that category. They are serial liars. People they call themselves brothers and sisters. People address them as pastor. But they know right in their heart that they are liars. As they are repenting now, the Lord is working on them now. And the compromisers that have repented, the Lord is working on them now. Yes, thank you. Begin to appreciate him for what the Lord is doing now. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to appreciate him for the restoration of glory that is taking place
in
him. Oh, thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you. That man that you falsify your age, your place of work, they don't want you to restitute. Yes, it can be difficult, but you can seek counseling. The Lord will help you. The Lord will help you because it's like you have sold out your glory. Those of you that have been falsifying informations about your personality, today the Lord wants you to repent because the Lord is doing something great in your life. Thank you, Jesus. Masinde ke ye muzo, muzoto koyaba santaka. Masinde ke ye muzo, muzoto koyaba santaka. Masinde ke ye muzo. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Yes. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
We just begin to confess that thank you, Jesus.
The
Lord said, because he has seen that many people's heart has been touched. He said, is the I am that I am. He says, his ways are past finding out. And there is no searching of his understanding. He said, many people have lost precious things because of compromise. But because they have repented this morning, you don't begin to say thank you, Jesus. You will say it with only aggression.
Please,
all the viewers at home, let's be serious now. God is not a comedian. Let's be serious.
God
will say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And you begin to see what the Lord will begin to do.
Because
the Lord has promised to do great and mighty things. Let's go now. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Yes. Jesus, our God is a faithful God. He is a promise keeper. He is standing on his promises. He has promised that as many that will cooperate with him this morning, that he will be automatically restored. Our restoration is taking place now. I see so many like being beautified now. Yes, there is a man in the spirit. He look very ugly. The Lord has created you with a glory. But the Lord has bastardized what the Lord has created with for you. Satan has bastardized what the Lord has created for you. And now the Lord is beautifying your life. Yes, the Lord is doing great and mighty things now. The Lord is doing great and mighty things now. Oh, thank you, Jesus. That youth that you have made up your mind. That you keep the bed on the fight in your marriage. The Lord is doing something great in your life. Because you have been defining the bed before, you have been defining that bed. Yes. But because of your resolution this morning, the Lord is beautifying your life now. So you will be celebrated.
Go
and write it down. You will surely be celebrated. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santa kaya. Masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santa kaya. Masinde ke yemozo. I can see a wave now, a wave of change. Yes, a wind of change is blustering now. It's blustering. Yes, the wind of change is blustering now. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Masinde ke yemozoto koyaba. Le mukaba. Masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santa kaya. Masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santa kaya. Masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santa kaya. That family that have already compromised. I say family. Because they know themselves. You are compromising because of this present hardship. This hardship will soon be over. Tough time never lasts, but tough people do. Because you have decided not to stop compromising this morning. The Lord will heal your wounded finances. Yes, the Lord will heal your wounded finances. Oh, thank you, Jesus. The Lord is doing many more things now. The Lord is healing the sick now. The Lord is healing the sick now. The Lord is touching the oppressed now. Whatever you cannot do before, begin to do it now. Yes. The Lord is doing wonders now. I can see that many people that have been in prison, the Lord is opening the prison gate for them. That woman that is tied down with chains, the Lord has broken that chain. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Masinde ke yemozo. Mozonto koyaba santaka. Masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santaka, masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santaka, masinde ke yemozo. Mozo mula, zende ke yemoya. Mayan mozoto koyaba santaka, masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santaka, masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santaka, masinde ke yemozo. Mozoto koyaba santaka. Masinde ke yemozo. Zende ke yemuba. Oh, thank you, Jesus. 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 There is a particular woman. You have been very sorrowful concerning the lifestyle of your husband. Your husband is extremely wayward. And you have been crying. It's as if there is no answer forthcoming. The Lord said, you should share up. He said, you will turn the heart of that your husband. Your husband will know the Lord. And your husband will serve the Lord. Begin to rejoice. That woman, begin to rejoice. For your day of joy has come. Sorrow may last for the night. Joy comes in the morning. Yes, the Lord is giving joy to the sorrowful now. The Lord is giving joy to the sorrowful now. Nobody can give joy except God. He's the source of all joy. He's the source of all joy. Yes, he's the source of all joy. No man, no mortal man can give joy except God. Yes, yes, yes. As many that are sorrowful, the Lord says you should share up. Yes, the Lord is giving you joy now. You will surely rejoice. Oh, thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
You don't want us to pray for the church. That the Lord will protect, provide, and the Lord will provide, protect, and preserve the church. That the fire of God upon every member of this church will not be quenched. And as many that are lukewarm at this point in time, because it's very dangerous to be lukewarm. The Lord will rekindle his fire upon their life. Let's pray that prayer seriously. Lord, we commit the church into your hand. That oh God, you will protect, you will provide, and you will preserve every member of this church till we are able to meet again, together again. Until that time, that we are. You will give us opportunity to gather again. Every member of this church will continue to provide for us. You will continue to protect us. You will continue to preserve us. The fire of God in our life will not be quenched. You will sustain us.
We
will not be lukewarm. We will not lose our focus. We will not derail. We will not miss our priority. We will not forfeit eternity at the expense of miserable vanities of this world. Masinde ke ye mozo, mozoso koyaba santa kaya. You will cater for the well-being of every member of this assembly, young and old, leaders and followers. You will cater for the well-being of everybody. Nobody will be left behind. Nobody will be left out. Masinde ke ye mozo, mozoto koyaba santa kaya. 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 Masinde ke ye mozo, mayan mozoto koyaba. Masinde ke ye mozo. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
All across the globe, the case of this coronavirus will be going down bit by bit. But people, government that will be careless, there is danger.
Fun awon eniyan ati awon adari ati won yo wa ni ipo akiyesara ewu wa nbe.
This is not the time to take a reckless decision.
eleyi ki se akoko lati se ipinu abi lati gbe igbese ti o to.
I want to pray for our leaders.
A fe gbadura fun awon adari
wa. That the Lord will guide them.
Ipinuluwa ko to won.
That the Lord will lead them.
Oluwa ko dari won.
To take the right decision especially at this critical moment.
Lati gbe igbese ti o dara ninu.
Let's turn to prayer. Let's turn to prayer. Masinde ke yemu zuntu oyaba santaka. Masinde ke yemu zuntu oyaba santaka. Masinde ke yemu zuntu
Lord, give them the grace, give them the enablement, the boldness and the courage to take such decision in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, I pray, Lord,
we help them. Some people will say, are we not praying for the present situation? The Lord knows better. His ways are past finding out. He said we should appreciate him. Because Nigeria is going to obtain mercy. Concerning the present situation, let's begin to appreciate him, for Nigeria is going to obtain mercy. For this nation is going to obtain mercy from the Lord. Father, we appreciate you.
Because your mercies are available to us today.
We appreciate you. We appreciate you. For the mercy you have been bestowing upon this nation, if it is for our sin, this nation is supposed to be a forgotten conclusion. We thank you for the mercies of the past. We thank you for the present mercy that you are going to show. Let's appreciate you for the mercies of the past. Let's appreciate you for the mercies of the past. If not for God, things will have been very, very serious, more than this.
We thank you
for what we still do with your mercy. We thank you. Oh, he's glorious in holiness and fearful in praises. Appreciate him. In Jesus' name we pray. He wants us to sing that our covenant song. Who is like unto thee? Oh Lord, who is like unto thee? Oh Lord, among the gods, who is like thee? Glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, always though. Wonders, hallelujah, hallelujah. Who is like unto thee? Oh,
my sin they came,
money by sin they came. Oh, money by sin they came. My young Ozondo boy. Oh, Lord. Among yes, yes. Thank you, Jesus. It's heavenly praises. Yes. You are glorious in holiness and fearful in praises. Always do his wonders. For the last time.
Hallelujah. Who is like unto thee?
Yes, the Lord is doing wonders now. In our nation. Yes. In the life of the people that have sung that song. Over tell me.
Oh Lord. Among the gods, who is like thee? Glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders, hallelujah.
Let's begin to appreciate him. Let's begin to appreciate. He said he has done a lot this morning. He said he has created, he has made a way, even in the sea. Because it's the word that we, it's the God that can lead, that we lead the highway and go and create a way right in the midst of the sea. Yes, his way is in the sea. Yes, thank you, Jesus. We appreciate you. 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 That jobless man, the Lord has given you the letter of employment. Yes, yes, yes. Immediately the lockdown is over, you will surely resume at your place of work. Because the Lord has given you an employment letter now. Oh, appreciate him, appreciate him. The Lord has done a lot this morning. The Lord has transformed lives. Many people's head have been changed. Yes, the Lord has changed many people's
heads.
All those unfortunate heads that you are carrying. The Lord has changed it for good. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Appreciate it. We should appreciate it because he has done great and mighty things this morning. He has done beautiful things this morning. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We appreciate you. We appreciate you.
Father, we appreciate you. Father, we appreciate you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
This time of lockdown, there are men at home now, women at home now, and you, that woman, you are coveting another woman's husband. It's not good. It's not good at all. Repent. Repent. I say repent before it is too late. And it shall be well with you.
Amen.
I say it shall be well with you.
Amen.
Shall be well in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you very much this morning. We are grateful unto you because of what you have done in our lives and in our families today. We thank you because of your love for us. You don't want us to come to this world, just walk through without leaving any mark. Our Father, we thank you for what you have opened our eyes to see today. What you have opened our ears to hear today because of this love to make us to reign with you in eternity. Our Father, we thank you today. Oh Lord, accept our praises in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we bless your name, even for what you are doing already in Nigeria. We thank you because at the end of the day, Nigeria will come out of this pandemic, oh Lord, victoriously in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, I pray all the families you are blessed today, Lord, the blessings will be permanent in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Lord, I pray today as many that have been compromising their faith, oh Lord, that because of the situation, they can no longer defend their faith, they can no longer stand on their feet, the backbone is destroyed. Mm. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus today, let there be restoration of your blessings, of your strength, of your faith in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Our Father, so that at the end of the day, Lord God Almighty, we will reign with you.
Amen.
When the saints shall be called up yonder, Lord God Almighty, we will not be left behind in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Our Father, we thank you
thank
today.
You,
we bless your name today. Because all these messages, all this word of eternity that have been coming unto us, Father, I pray none of them will witness against us on the last day in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name, I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We thank God once again for what he has done in our lives, in our families today. The same thing will happen on Thursday. And I want to encourage us. Call your neighbors. Call your friends. To come and benefit from what the Lord is giving us on this mountain. And there is no way you and them, those people you will have called, there is no way you people will remain the same. And my prayer is that the blessings of today, the blessings to come,
will
be permanent in our life.
Amen.
And it shall be well in Jesus.
Amen.
The bank and the account number is being displayed on the screen. Copy it. And pay your tithe and offering. For more of God's blessings. Till we meet next time on Thursday.
Thursday.
Remain blessed.